One of our community members has asked us to come up with ideas for him. We've done three. However, we've made it part one and part two. In this video, we're doing the first logo, and we're going to be uploading the second video doing the two other videos. Let's jump in on Canva and do this. Once you've opened up your blank canvas, you're going to go to your shapes and you're going to add a square shape, or you can press R for rectangle. Since I don't have a color scheme for Rye, we're going to pick any color that we want that's going to pop. So I always love red and black. I'm going to go with red, and I'm going to change this to red. And the background, I'm going to make that black. So once you've added your square shape, you're going to reduce it, rotate it, and duplicate the shape, rotate that to create a home-like look-alike or a house look-alike. Add it on top of the other shape and then align it. And then drag it to create a longish line. And then duplicate the first shape, and then move it to the last and align it. Next, you're gonna press R for rectangle again and reduce that to a rectangle-ish shape so that you're able to create a white square. I'm gonna just make things easy for all of us and change it back to white so that we don't have to worry when we have to convert it to 3D. So add it on your first house shape so that it creates that nice flat look, and then copy the two shapes, duplicate them, and add them to the next line so that you create a second shape. So, and then move this square shape to create a gap in between the two shapes. You can always move this so that it doesn't overlap and it doesn't make your work look bad. Awesomeness. Now level up the two lines, and the easiest way to do that is to go to your file and switch on your lines so that you have everything. Move your ruler, edit there so that you have perfect straight lines. Cool. Then I'm going to duplicate this shape, add it on our last home, and then hide our shape so that it looks like that. And then duplicate the shape, rotate it, and then align it on top of that house. Make sure that it is perfectly aligned. Like that. And last thing, duplicate this white shape and add it on our home so that you have a level shape. The last thing that you're going to do is to press R for rectangle, and then you can create windows. So we're going to just create a square shape, make them slightly corner rounded, and then have them have a different color. So in order for us to have a beautiful design, the second house we're going to make red, the first one we're going to make black. And we're going to make the first house's windows this one. We're going to group those, duplicate, and then have windows on the second house as well. Then your last bit is to add the name of the business. You're going to press T for text. And you're going to change the font and make it a nice big Anton font. And you're going to type the name of the business. Since we are creating for Rye properties, we want everything to be aligned. So we're going to select our design, and we're gonna group it, and we're gonna make it smaller, add it to our design. Then we're going to make the name of the business nice and big and huge, and we're gonna have it align with the icon that we've created for the business. And you're gonna align it, and then choose your letter spacing, spread it out a little bit so that it is aligned like that. Then you're going to add another T for text to tell everybody this is Rye Properties. We're gonna use open source for the tagline. Because gaps do so well, we're going to highlight our group, and we're gonna ungroup the group, and we're gonna select the shapes that we want to go over our design and create the beautiful gaps that we absolutely love. So we're gonna select this shape, and we're gonna use the shape's layers, and we're gonna bring it to front. And this other shape as well, we can always go to layers and pick the other red shape. So we've selected this one, it's on top. We want this shape as well to be on top. So you're gonna go to your layers and just drag it to be on top so that it looks like that. Great stuff. Now that it's aligned and it looks beautiful, we're gonna press R for rectangle, and we're gonna do the last gap shape of our logo. So we're going to zoom in and create a white rectangle or a white shape that we're going to be using to create the gaps. What we're interested in here is making the gap over there. I'm just gonna duplicate that, just put it on the side, and then finish off here. So I want the red shape to be on top, therefore I'm gonna select the red shape, and I'm gonna bring it to front. And always adjust your shape if you don't like the gap size. And then you do exactly the same on the other side. I'm gonna send it backward. I'm gonna send it again backward. Our front shape, I want it to be on top. Great stuff. I hope I haven't lost you. The last bit is to create a beautiful gap over there. So I'm gonna press R for rectangle, do my little thing, change this to white, and bring it over here so that we have a gorgeous gap in between there. I think the only thing I don't like are these windows. I don't like them. So I'm gonna go to layers and just change the shape and make them a little bit squish. Love, love, love. Can I interrupt the video real quick? We have a logo dedicated section on our Be a Canva Expert on Udemy course. If you go and you access our course material as well as the curriculum, We have a section that has 11 lectures on Canva. We do have an 86% special currently. The link is in the description below. Go grab the course. Let's go back to our logo designs. I've been on Photopea and converted to 3D. I'm a fan of Photopea. I love this one that we've created, number one. So you're going to go share and you're going to go download. And you're going to download this as a transparent background. But we want to download logo number one. So we're going to select logo number one. First of all, you're going to unselect everything and pick page one and click on done and then download. Once it's downloading nicely like this, you're going to scroll down and add a page. Then you're going to grab your logo, the PNG, you're going to upload it to Canva. And it has all of those extra shapes that we've created. We can't take it to Photopea looking like this. So we're going to make it nice and big. And then we're going to go click edit photo. And you're going to use the old Canva photo editor. So you're going to click on click here to use the old version. And you revert to old version. And then you click on edit image again. And then you remove the background. Because the old background remover managed just to take off the extra whites for us. And we love it for that. Once it has taken everything away, you're going to click on apply. And then you are able to download your design. We're going to go to share and we're going to click on download. We're going to make sure that the transparent background is picked. And you're going to unselect everything. And you're going to select page 4. And you're going to click done and then you're going to download it. Then you access Photopea online, the photo editor that makes us showcase our work. Then you're going to click on templates. I just think because it's real estate, we're going to pick the paper logo mockup template. You can use any mockup you want. Then you select it, then you click on photopea.com. After it opens up, you're going to double click where it says your logo here on the checkered box. You're going to double click and then it opens up the designer's example. You can always hide it first or hide it later, doesn't matter. You click on the eye, then you find your design and you drag it to the canvas and you align it and you make it nice and big the way that you want and you press Command S or Control S to change it to a smart object. And then you click on the first page or the first link to access your gorgeous, beautiful design that you've created on Canva and Photopea. Then you're gonna go File, Export as PNG, and then you have your design up and running. If you want more ideas of these shapes, logos that we've done on Canva, go access our playlist. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on part 2.